please.
Okay, it's just gonna come to him now. No, if you can keep him busy, dead busy, I can deal with this. Attacker, our next special technique is increased. It knows special techniques. Okay then. Strength. Yeah, even as my strength wanes, my courage surges. My god, Windows, I don't give a shit about updates. True courage is found even on the brink of death. I will defeat you, monster. God. Heal yourself. You failed. Okay then, we'll try this again. This time, Windows won't kick me out. Let's out-tap for a second. I know I should have done this before. If it's a cutscene, I'll be fine. Yeah. Okay, just focus fire the big guy down. Don't worry about the anyone else. Mind. Worry about everyone else. Maybe he can handle the big guy, but can't handle the rest. And he can have one giant orb, you know, smacking around but not holding. Oh, he actually does use life surge. That's cool. Life Surge, Shrink. You can kill these. Protect him, because he's an idiot. And Spirit Bonded with my half. Better now. Christ. These are its. You know, subjects. I thought these just were nearby in aggro or something. No. It's got fucking elementals as subjects. The monster trainer, Twain. You shan't find much sport in these two. Come back another day, my friend. Well done, Drumkaran. You have completed the trial. I trust you now see the courage of my words. Hurling yourself into midst of danger is not courage. It's folly. No, this proves nothing. I refuse. I refuse to accept. You refuse to accept the weakness within you. No, Drumkaran. Leave him be. Your work here is done. Return to the guild. I shall see you there presently. It will be a bit much to expect him to immediately accept this, you know, accept Adam like that, because, like, as you saw, even in death, he was still really into thinking he could win, because of his, Christ, there's a lot of these people doing this spam shite. You know, like, just how into that, you know, courage fixation thing. There's no way he would ever accept this. Well, at least not right now. Maybe he'll get some sense slapped into him a bit further and he'll cop on. But yeah, it's not surprising that he didn't accept that. I will not lie to you. You are no match for the Lord of the Bramble Patch. Had you betrayed any hint of fear, he would have gored you in a space of a moment and feasted on your entrails. But you stood your ground, holding to your composure and resolve. Thus you were able to stare terror in the face and survive unscathed. Well done, Drumkaran. You've overcome the greatest hurdle in the quest to become a master of your own courage. You may now bring to bear the full extent of your abilities upon even the mightiest of foes. As for Falquis, well, if there's any shred of reason left in him, you have learned the self-same lesson as you today. Painful through the experience, though the experience must have been, one can only hope it will serve to open his eyes to the truth. Hopefully, the few broken bones will point him in the right direction. Go forth, Drumkaran, and prepare yourself for further trials. I look forward to our next meeting. Okay, that's inferior, actually, to what I have now. So I'll take the iron salad. As these are inferior. Well, that's better magic defense, but I don't care. I'll take this. Okay, got the lance and the iron sword. Oscar, really? No, it's not. Hang on. Yeah, it's here. Over here. So yeah, go return, and then if I just find the chocobo person, they'll bring me all the way over here. Of course, I could go to Lanoska and get a boat over, but I can't be bothered to start running around Lanoska. Airport. Nald'thal. I actually have to run back inside. That fucked me outdoors. Outside. Oh, that background looks painted on. Whenever they do that kind of thing, it always looks wrong. Like, they get the perspective and whatnot wrong. It just doesn't work right. I can understand why they do it, and and whatnot, but it's just, I think I know why they do it and all that, but it just doesn't look right. It just doesn't work right, and it kind of ends up being a little annoying. One extreme example was, the Bureau XCOM Declassified. I think it'll be at the wrong angle. Like, you'll be looking into a shop, but it looks like the shop's at a weird angle compared to how it actually is. Like, the inside of it's at a different angle, like, slope to the outside of the store. Actually, Deus Ex Human Revolution was pretty bad about it. When you're in Hengshaw, all the stores... you can find, like, a window in, like, an apartment building that just goes straight into a corridor with two double doors at the end with a bit of glass. If you're looking at the trains, you see that same thing reflected on their windows. Well, looking through the windows, you see the same thing. It's actually really weird and kind of annoying. Same with Jensen's glasses. There's something being reflected in them, but it's not what's in front of them. It's like some generic storefronts or whatever. It makes sense that they wouldn't be reflecting exactly what's in front of them. That'd be really costly or extra work to do, and as such, it's easier to do with the way they did it, I'm sure. I figure. But it's, again, it ends up making it look weird. Oh, I can actually change while I'm doing this. Sign. Back on. And what's this? Bigger fish to fry. And one day I will go down and actually turn in the seat to change thing when I can be bothered. Ooh, excuse me. For now, I want to continue on with the main questline as much as possible, because, like I was saying before, I end up feeling like I'm burning out with the game, or I'm paranoid that I will feel like that. What's going on? Okay, I don't think this is meant to happen. Without having out for a second. Something's going weird in the background. Okay, it's fine now. Don't remember what I was saying. You see him? Nope. Just acknowledge my presence by bobbling their head after me. Don't remember what I was saying. Oh yeah, I'm paranoid about burning out, so I just want... Oh, she's adorable. Just want to continue doing with the main questline. Deep in the desert of my heart, a lonely flower blooms, yearning for the heavens above to quench my thirst for you. Tra-loo-loo-loo-loo-loo. Wow. I would thank you not to sneak up on me like that. Now, please be advised that this is private property. Unless you have pertinent business here, I must ask you to... Here at the beheaded Tancred. My sincerest apologies. May I please have your name? That's a cool hat she has. Dromkaren Taladros. Ah, here you are. I bid you welcome to the Waking Sands, headquarters of the Scions of the Seventh Dawn. My name is Tataru, and I look forward to assisting you during your time with us. This is adorable. The Ascendant is within the Sower. I shall let her know to expect you. I take it you're drunk, Ren, Tal'Dorei. Tataru sent word that you had arrived. Lady Minfila has eagerly awaited your coming. This way, if you please. $500 gil? Or that? Let me check my wrist items. The weather wristlets are fine. Don't need to change them, so I'll go with this.
So you're the adventurer of whom I've heard so much.
Just cool pants. Well, cloak, mainly.
Well met, friend. My name is Minfilia, and I lead the Scions of the Seventh Dawn.
Minfilia. Alright.
I have awaited your coming. Please, be at ease. You are among friends here. No doubt you are ripe to burst with questions, but have patience. All will be revealed in time. First, let me begin by telling you who we are and what we do. We are the Scions of the Seventh Dawn, an order that transcends political boundaries. Our single objective is the preservation of the future of Eorzea.
One thing I was actually thinking was, you remember how we saw those in a walking in the forest, her on the dock and him in Ul'dah? I figure they must be the Gardenian version of him. They send you here if you start off in Gardenia. She is the Lunoskan version. So if you start off in Lunoska, you're sent here by her. I figure anyway. So we get to see an extra bit of story if you say have one character in each part. So, yeah.
Among our gravest concerns are the godlike beings known as the Primals. Their existence is a bane upon Eorzea, nay, the world at large, and we have striven to find a lasting solution to the threat they pose. Our order is home to a number of individuals who, like you, possess a rare and special talent. This talent takes various forms, but one holds particular interest for us. Tell me, have you ever experienced a sudden, inexplicable loss of consciousness?
Every Friday night.
Have you ever had the sensation of being pulled away from reality? Felt as though you were hovering in space, a mind without a body?
Every Friday night.
All these things are the manifestations of your talent.
Alcohol.
Yours is the power to transcend the boundaries of the soul. A power known as the Echo.
Okay then.
The Echo allows you to pass through the walls of a man's soul and hear the resonations of his past.
Okay then. Well, that's impressive.
You will be there in his memories, and see things as he saw them. You may even interact with that which you see, though you cannot change the outcome of events.
Alright then. I wonder, if you interact with them, will you change how they remember it? Or can you just, say if you know someone who...